So, well, originally I actually tried to do a different video of this. I decided Croc instead, just because I wanted to play something different. So, how's it going, guys? This is Dolan 2K5. I'm pretty much just going to start new videos, finally, after a long hiatus. And pretty much just do recording of older, primarily 5th gen games. I'm going to probably go to Super Nintendo, I'll do N64, stuff like that. But Sega Saturn is going to be my primary thing because, well, Sega Saturn is freaking awesome. And there's not enough videos actually showing it in good quality. So... pretty much my setup is this one's hooked up to a SCART, to an HDMI converter, then it's going into a capture card, and then going to my HDTV. 4K HDTV. And if anyone actually remembers Croc, this game was interesting, primarily for the fact that, well, it tried to be Mario on something that it wasn't. Because, well, there was so many ideas with being 3D platformers, and well, basically, it worked all that well. Croc was one of those that, in my opinion, worked. It actually looks pretty good, all things. But it does have a lot more warping than this one, so take it for what it is. But one thing I really like about this is that I can actually go around circles, because the 3D analog controller allows it. Although a lot of people, not a lot, but I've heard people have problems with using the 3D analog controller in this game. Because the game is originally made for tank controls, and the 3D analog controller breaks. Hello. Yeah, anyway. As I said earlier, this is one of my It's been forever since I played this game. I got it with my Sega Saturn back in 2001. Yeah, so I was like, this is fun. And basically, when it came to 3D games, if I wanted to play 3D games, there wasn't very many available, so here we go. I decided to play and try out Croc quite a bit. Now, the thing is, I've actually never gone through this, primarily because the later levels of platforming designs become an absolute chore to play through. Who knows, maybe this will actually get me back into trying to play all the way through this game. I don't imagine it's going to be so many people interested in watching Croc's video. I have a feeling that this question will be played on the 3D analog controller doesn't generally. Oh my god, I can't even get through that door very well. Does a generally decent job compared to using a D-pad, because platforms and tank controls. The problems I have with this game. Is it for us? Did I get all the crystals? Oh, right. Whoa! Ow! I forgot if this thing's there. I was like, what's here? Oh, he is there. Platformers. Gobbos having 3 million collectibles for whatever reason. Although this one isn't as bad as Crash Bandicoot. This still has the collect these to do this, collect these to do this mentality. And if you don't collect them all, you're not beating the whole game, and you don't get all the secrets. Mario 64 is first one of the category, but Mario 64 is also better in this game, so. That being said, playing games like this on the Sega Saturn remind me of how I just don't care about Crash Bandicoot. Maybe it's because I've been the Sega Saturn fanboy back in the day, even though I didn't get a Saturn until 2001. That I can't see why people loved Crash Bandicoot. I tried. I tried to love that game. Tried to get into it. And it just isn't that special. I almost prefer this game. Which is kind of a genius. There's so many things in this Crash Bandicoot. During the Sega Saturn's life. Eventually, it didn't come out until 2000. Also, the fact that this Saturn controller's 3D pad is wrapping around things that I'm trying to pick up and having problems with stuff. Yeah,
technically happy I only got that many, but
yeah,
I'll survive. I'm trying to get to the first mini boss, and then I'll probably call it quits for this episode. But if I'm going to start being all picky about how many of these gobbos I pick up every level, I just realized I did not memorize any of this stuff. Too many years since I played this. Saturn is an absolute disaster when it comes to technical specifications. Definitely had untapped potential, but jump by Shenmue and I wish it's easy to go ahead and be like, oh yeah, we decided to release Shenmue's beta on Saturn. Still try to have problems with me, I don't know, standing on a platform, but can't get me with that trick. Because going straight on this game is not an option. Thank you. stuck on all the freaking doors, all the... many times in this game, because you're pretty much just forced to change how it play it just to get that, or just jumping, but you don't have enough time to jump, so you're kind of stuck no matter what. Alright, Lair of the Feeble, here's finally the first boss. This I do love me some 5th gen real-time cutscenes. Those are some of the best. And I have one really... boss fight. It doesn't go straight into the boss fight. I'm just gonna go into the fight, and generally the boss fights actually look better than the same thing too. much this boss fight is so much easier than the analog stick because of the fact that it's easier to go across all the ice. Should be it. This is kind of all a test run, honestly, since I got actually through that boss fight. Yeah, there's a secret level to get all the gobbles. Every time after a mini boss, there is a secret level to find all the gobbles beforehand. But I'm not worried about it. Anyways, that's all I got for the day. If you actually like what you see, give me a go at a like and subscribe, and also remember the fact that I'm only giving this a shot. I'm not sure if I'm going to keep going with Dark Croc, or I'm going to try to do many different episodes. So, anyways, thanks for watching. Don't take it.